Slide 1. Welcome to Recording Techniques for Method Study video. In this video, we will describe the recording techniques for method study. After going through this video, you must be able to recognize the recording techniques for method study. There are many recording techniques used by organizations for carrying out method study. However, the managers identify the most appropriate technique that will highlight any deficiencies in the original method and help to find improvements and implement them. The main techniques can be broadly grouped into charts and diagrams. Charts are the most popular way of recording facts related to activities on the job. Two types of charts are used for recording purpose. The first type of chart is used for recording the sequence of steps or events that occur. The second type of chart records the sequence of steps on a time scale. These are the charts used for recording the process sequence. Next, let's look at each one of them in detail. This is also referred to as the operation process chart. This chart gives the overall picture of the process and it records only the major activities. In this chart, symbols are used to show the major sequence of operations and inspections. Symbols for operation and inspection are added along with a brief note on their nature. The operation symbol is used to record a step or an action or an event where the object changes its physical shape or chemical composition. Next, let's look at the symbols used in process chart. These are symbols used in process chart. Next, let's look at an example. The operation symbol is used to record a step or an action or an event where the object changes its physical shape or chemical composition. For example, drilling a hole in a metal bar. The inspection symbol is used to record the action of checking the quality or specifications or quantity of the object. For example, visual inspection for damaged potatoes in the process of producing potato chips. Each operation and inspection is uniquely numbered starting from 1. This chart is the extension of outline process chart. It shows the activity of the operation, inspection, storage, transportation, and delay. The chart provides the sequence of all the events in a process and depicts what a worker does, what happens to raw material, and how equipment is used. These charts record all the events in detail and are quite lengthy. Hence, these charts are the most preferred in improving the process. Symbols used to create the flowchart are operation, inspection, delay, transport, and storage. Transport symbol is used to record the movement of men, material, and equipment. For example, movement of the hot potato chips along the conveyor belt. Cool the chips and remove the excess oil. Delay symbol is used to record stoppages in the process. For example, waiting for the forklift to unload or load the containers to the truck. Storage symbol is used to depict items under authorized custody for further use or dispatch. For example, raw materials kept in a warehouse storage. Next, let's see types of flowchart used. Three types of flowcharts are used. Man-type flowchart, used to record human activities. Equipment-type flowchart, used to record how the machines and equipments are utilized. Material-type flowchart, used to record what happens to the material. Let's move on to the next chart. This chart is also known as an operator process chart. It is used to record the hand movements of workers in detail with respect to the movement of other workers in a single workplace. Separate charts are created for the left hand and right hand movements. Synchronized movements of both the hands are depicted opposite to each other on the charts. This chart aids in visualizing the process sequence for repetitive tasks and also in improving the workplace layout. Next, let's look at the symbols used in two-handed chart. The five symbols used to create the flowcharts are also used in the creation of the two-handed chart, except that the way in which the inspection and storage symbols are used differs. The inspection symbol is used to record the movement of touch or feel. The storage symbol is used to record the gripping or holding movement of the hand. Multiple activity chart. This chart is used to record the activity of a worker in relation to another worker, machine or equipment on a common time scale. Travel chart. This chart is a tabular record used to present quantitative data about the movement of the workers, material or equipment between any number of places in a given time period, SIMO, or simultaneous motion cycle chart. This chart is used for recording in micro motion study. Next, let's study these charts in detail. It is used to study the idle time of men and equipment, number of machines operated by one worker, and number of workers required in a team to complete a job. It consists of a series of bars on a common time scale. Two symbols are used to create this chart. A hashed column is used to depict working time, and a blank column is used to depict idle time. Each task is broken down into smaller operations, which are then recorded using the symbols. The time taken for each operation is found using a stopwatch. Then, bars are placed on a time scale, which begins from zero and ends with cycle time for the task. Let's move on to the next chart. A travel chart consists of a big square that contains a number of squares, and each small square represents a workstation. In a travel chart, a diagonal is drawn from top left to bottom right. These charts are best suited in the condition when the pattern of movements is complex. Let's move on to next chart. SIMO chart records the rapid movements of a part of a worker's body for short durations on a common time scale. This is used for micro motion analysis of repetitive jobs. The process of constructing a SIMO chart is very complex and needs costly equipment. Hence, it is used only when the benefits from such study outweigh the cost of conducting